Greetings, Outlanders, and welcome back to the Morrowind Pacifist Challenge. We last left off just off the docks in Voss, which is a very strange little town. It's essentially the Austin, Texas of the Grayslands. It's a little slice of weirdness and progressivism in a sea of ignorance. This unique cultural blend, which is exemplified by the mix of Imperial and Telvanni architecture, is mostly due to the new management of the town, an up-and-coming Telvanni wizard, which we probably want to speak to. Then again, we don't really have a lot of Rising Force potions anymore, do we? Yeah, that's a problem. Do we have, like, a falling potion? No, I don't think we have slow fall. He might have to wait, but that's alright, because we have to come back here for the main quest anyways. The Ahamusa are one of the major tribes who name you Nereverine when everything's said and done. So, we'll be in this neck of the woods sooner rather than later. If we follow the coast, we should be able to find the Ahamusa camp pretty well. There's also these guys. They're pack Brahmin thieves. Pack Brahmin? No, this isn't Fallout. Pack Guar.
Well, head out.
You guys have anything to say? No. We need to find the guy they stole the Guar from before we can actually do their quests, which may involve killing them, so maybe hold off on that. There's the camp. I know some people are really probably dying to see me tackle the main quest line and all that, but I'm going to be honest. I don't know if we're ready for it. I don't know how long we're going to be till we are ready for it. We can't really deal with large groups of enemies in dungeons still. We've got Calm Creature, that's nice. We do have Calm Humanoid. That's not that good. 30 points is not a lot when it comes to humanoids, I don't think.
Please join me.
Who do we want to talk to? I guess I seek a healer. Mamea, okay.
I'm never too busy for good talk.
If I know Wise Women, which I do, she's probably in one of these tents off to the side.
There's someone watching me.
No.
I can tell.
You're Sununu Murpal, okay. I'd like to arrange a meeting. Not meet with the Sigarnian. I might send my apprentice, Minabibi. It is time she saw how foreigners live and left her childish notions behind. Does not respect Ashlander ways. She's like a sister to every foreigner who visits the camp. Okay, well, that sounds like exactly the kind of person we want to arrange a meeting. Fabel Tomb is west of the camp. I think I remember this quest. Yeah, this quest is actually undoable because we have to kill a ghost. So, I guess we have to go back in time. Now we still have a decent number of quests. We've unlocked some more Mages Guild quests. And we could probably head to Vivec and do the Master Thief quests, as well as, what is it, the Balmolagmar? Sounds like a Bionicle. Those quests. But I think what we're gonna focus on right now is this. So we need to find Mail Kashishi, which is a Daedric Ruin from the sounds of it. I think she's a worshipper of Sheogorath? And she's right in the entrance. You don't have to fight through a bunch of worshippers to get to her. But I think the outside will have Daedra, so we do have invisibility and a lot of magic potions, honestly. So we need to head east from Ald Velothi. I think I know which one that is, right? No. No, wait, no, that's the Urshalaku one. So, I think it's right around here. It's the one between Ald Velothi and the other place. Cool? Is it cool? I think it's cool. Let me check. I've heard of Solstheim. I believe there's an Imperial fort up there, Fort Frostmouth or something. If you want to go there, check around in Cool. There may be a ship that'll take you. Yes, Cool. Also, we now have the Solstheim quest on us. I mean, we're going to be doing that eventually. An island to the north. Great. Where do we want to go to start this? I guess Alruin's probably a good spot. Before we head off into parts unknown, however, why don't we do something about this gold that's burning a hole in our pocket, starting with some training from our good buddy Caius, who's actually a pretty good hand-to-hand and unarmored trainer, which are things we desperately need. And there we go, 5 more intelligence and 5 more speed. And we've still got almost all of our cash. We could do that a couple of times. Alright, it's another level up. And thanks to Ajira here over at the Mage's Guild, these intelligence level ups are not costing us that much. Same cannot be said for Caius's high level training, which costs an arm and a leg. And there we have it, folks. That's basically all of our money, but it has brought us up to speed 75 and intelligence 70. And as much value as this book gives us as a recurring gag, it does weigh 3 weight. And one of the easiest ways to boost your speed is to just lose weight, much like in real life. So let's give some stuff to our old friend Raylan here. Alright, we have halved our weight, and we are now moving about as fast as a heavy armor boots of blinding speed character, which is probably about as good as we're gonna get.
Why walk when you can ride?
Exactly. Why walk when you can ride? I just took the Silt Strider to Cool, which is all the way up here, the northern part of Vardenfell. There's a long winding route from between Margun and Aldruin, I think, is where it connects, and then it goes all the way down to Caldera and over here to Narmok, but we're not going to do that because it's long, windy, and full of danger. Now, is there anything we actually want to do in Cool itself? I know there's a couple of quests in here. Actually, no, there's not a couple of quests in here. I'm thinking of Ald Valathi. Really, the only interesting thing in here, aside from fast travel to Solstheim, is there is a smuggler's hideout, an island, just over there. And it's got a pilgrim's lantern, which is one of the best lanterns in the game, because it's got a very big light radius, and it has a really long timer. It's basically an infinite lamp, which is great, because most lanterns and torches and stuff like that have very short fuses. But we want to be heading that way, west, towards Ald Valathi and the Daedric Ruin. This ought to be fun. I don't know how that didn't see us. I'm just gonna count our blessings. Oh, want to stay away from those guys. Honestly, I'd rather take you on, because you, I can easily calm creature. Calm creature is much more effective than calm humanoid. From what I remember, which is from Oblivion and Skyrim. I've never used Calm in these games, or in this game specifically, but I imagine Calm Humanoid is still less effective than Calm Creature. Here's the ruin we're after. Hopefully we won't run into too many Daedra. In fact, why don't we just... we have 47. Let's drink a potion and then cast Hide. Alright, now we just run. We run in, and if Hyde runs out, we cast it again and start drinking another potion. Yep, that's what I was afraid of. This is the right place, right? No. East from Ald Valathi until I reach the mountains, then follow the mountains south. Huh. Okay, well, let's just head to Ald Valathi then. Yeah, here's Ald Valathi. Not a lot here, unless you're doing Redoran stuff or Imperial Legion stuff, which we could do. Something I forgot is that we don't have to like solve the deed quest the right way. We could just get the deed from that lady's house, and that's like solving the quest. You don't have to kill anybody, which sounds great, but also we are leaving a man's murder unsolved, which is not great. But what are you gonna do? So we want to head east from Ald Valathi until we hit the mountains. Okay, this is a very strange... I don't think I remember this place. I did this quest. I had to have done this quest. I've done all the quests. That's probably why I don't remember it. Everything sort of just blends together after a while. It's sort of like playing all the Pokemon up until Sun and Moon and just forgetting the past couple generations. Is he gonna stop falling? He is gonna stop falling. Okay, well, that's good. What is it? I think it's Oblivion, where they'll, if you try and go invisible while they can see you and are chasing you, they'll keep chasing you to a degree. Which means we should probably start doing more Magicka potions. Oh, right, that gets rid of our invisibility. Okay. Calming is cheaper than invisibility, so let's do that unless we absolutely have to. We're back where we started. Why does it say east from Aldlothi if it's just going to hit Cool? Why doesn't it just say east from Cool? This is Morrowind travel instructions in a nutshell. Oh, I think I know where we're going. We're going to the Daedric Ruin that has the kidnapped lady in it. No, wait, no, she's in that one over there. Her husband is over here. So where's this ruin? We want to head south from the ruin. I mean, from the mountain. I guess we'll find it sooner or later. Yep, there he is. I'm not rescuing your wife right now. Sorry. He shouldn't get attacked by wildlife. He'll still be there to do the quest later. A lot of scribs out here. Not that I mind. I do like scribs. This looks like the place. See a scamp. Scamps aren't too bad. If we're going in there, we might as well just hide and drink a potion again. I think she's in the entrance. I remember correctly, crouching does not break invisibility, right? Yes. Okay, so now we are no longer invisible. Great. If we need to go invisible, we can. Is it you? You, okay. She's diseased and has ash chancre. I can't tell. Everybody in this game looks like they have ash chancre. I will heal you. I shall use a spell. Orc magic has little effect on orcs? Since when? Is that a thing? Are they like dwarves in Dragon Age? Oh, failed casting. That's great. We have really low restoration skill, don't we? Chance is 49. Okay. Oh, that did it. Get out of here. I was... we're gonna explore a little bit. This is probably a good way to get some loot. We'll have a finger on Omcivi? Or let's just keep using divines. We have way more divines than Omcivis. We'll just try and steal some stuff and get out of here. Quama, Warrior, Diamond, Emerald, Standard, Silence. Okay. These guys are all here. Let's go back to hiding. Okay. That's a lot of stuff. Okay. Do we want to just grab everything that's visible and get out of here? Yeah, I don't think we want to spend time doing these lock chests. Okay. Grab structure.
Well met, Outlander.
Guys don't seem too hostile, actually. That's nice. Hi. What about you? Okay, so these guys are just totally fine with us. That's new. Are they gonna mind us stealing things?
Greetings, Outlander. I think I've heard of you before.
I guess this is from our high personality. Yeah, let's start breaking into things, see how they react. I don't think they are. This is cool. This is new. I mean, this actually, like, does stuff for us. I always thought personality was kind of a waste, but if it literally lets you walk all over bandit camps, that's pretty cool. Now, I'm willing to bet that one of these offerings here will summon a Daedra, and I've had bad luck with these in that sometimes they just crash my game, so I just saved before this. Let's see if that happens. Yep, Daedra. Okay, let's divine out of here. That hurt. How much did that hurt? Decent amount. It's a good thing we weren't sticking around after that. Please stop hurting. Okay, good. We're alright. So we have a Bone Lord Grand Soul Gem, which is worth 20,000. Do we want to actually use that on, like, say, our skirt? To make our skirt really good? It's not going to be a permanent enchantment, because we can't really do those without just, killing something, as I've found out. But we could still get something nice, like, say, levitate or something. Ah, there's a question. Do we want to enchant our fur helm, which has 7 enchantment points, or our exquisite sir? That has 60. Maybe that's probably a better idea. 100 charge, that's not bad. Now, what could we do? Levitate's probably a good call. 10 levitate for 20 seconds would cost 24,000 gold. It would have a cast cost of 28, but it would only use 30 of the enchantment. I think I could buff it, but that's only going to increase how much it costs. Alright, so that's 17 for 21 would be 50 cast cost and 100 charge, so you could use it twice. Again, a whole bunch of money that we don't have. I might just sell this to the crab at some point, because we're doing alright. Without constant effect stuff, I mean, we might as well be using potions and spells and stuff, right? Have I shown compassion to Bulfim Cross Sugars? I have. You cured her and proven your compassion. You might be interested in this book, which is an important lesson on the rewards of compassion. Were you able to preserve the potion? Yes, I have it right here. Performed beyond my expectations. Thank you. You're indeed resourceful as well as compassionate. Ready for your further duties? I am indeed. A man in Surim named Elvil Vidron is a false incarnate. Claims to be the Nereverine and makes prophecies of doom. Clearly a heretic. Convince him that he's mistaken or Vault fails. Prove it by killing him. If he is the Nereverine, he is protected by prophecy and cannot die. So yeah, remember that guy in the red light district of Surim just running around shouting about the end of days? Let's go talk to that guy. Hey, buddy. I need to talk to you about not being the Nereverine. You've had visions, huh? I have experienced the waking dream. But it's not you, it's me. He will seek penance for his sins. Well, good. That was easy enough. I have chastised the false incarnate. Glad we did not kill him. Me too! Potions of healing, nice. Can we advance? No, more experience. Okay, what do you have? Make the pilgrimage to Margon. Go to the shrine of Margon, read the inscription on the rocks, and imitate Vivec's actions. Okay, just a short trip to Margon, and then a walk to the temple. Magic Rock of Margon. Here, Maroon Stagon held this rock high above the Dunmer. Vivec taunted Maroon Stagon so that Dagon threw the rock at Vivec instead of the people. Okay. And there's a Daedra here. I am a Daedra. If you are a pilgrim, read the inscription on the stupid rock. Oh. You don't sound too happy about being here. We're gonna taunt you. Our threats are weak like our flesh. Well, I mean, our flesh is pretty weak. Continue with your insults, mortal. I long to feast on your marrow. Okay. Fine words from one born from the wrong end of a guar. What is the... Would that be the mouth? That's a terrifying image. This game's rated E, right? Huh. Okay, I forget what to do at this point. Ow!
What was that?
Talk to the priest. Still know what to do. You've done well. Wisdom and praise be unto you. Culminate your pilgrimage by reading the inscription. Oh, I have to read it again. Alright, stop attacking me, buddy. Okay, is he just gonna keep attacking me? I don't... It's very rude. Let's try calming him. Would he count as a creature or a humanoid? Let's find out. Okay, he's not a humanoid. He's a creature, and he's calmed. Okay, cool. So, in this game, unlike Oblivion, Dremora are creatures. I guess that makes sense. They have like a unique model. It's not like they're wearing Daedric armor.
Hello.
You know, I'm glad this is my last playthrough of Morrowind for a while, because I don't think I could go back to the normal, like, everyone being rude to you all the time. After this, like, everyone's so pleasant to us. It's nice. Alright, I have made the pilgrimage. Sounds like I handled an Adra well. Thank you. Another book, okay. More duties? Oh, not ready. Until then, speak with Uhu Leilarin in Ghostgate or Endirin Lethan in Vivec. What am I missing for temple updates? One skill at 40. Unarmored is at 40, isn't it? No, it's at 34. We could get it to 40 pretty fast. But we don't really have enough points to start, like, leveling. I guess we could go sell the Grand Soul Gem, and then we'll definitely have enough cash to start leveling up again. Officer, are you okay? Shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. All right, back to Vivec, where we have a couple of new quest givers we can talk to. We have Jim Stacy, the leader of the Thieves Guild. Or I should say, the leader of the Morrowind faction of the Thieves Guild. I think the Grey Fox is supposed to be the leader right now of the Thieves Guild overall. They don't mention him because this is, like, years before Oblivion was even in production. Actually, that's not true. They probably started working on Oblivion right after this game came out, or even beforehand. What do you know about Jim? I can find him through that door. Okay. Door's locked. Are you gonna mind? I don't think he's gonna mind, but just in case. Yo, Jim! And hey, Crazy Legs. What a name. That's very rude.
Stay as long as you like.
I guess I did call him Crazy Legs. A privilege to talk with you. Jim Stacy may have jobs for us, but we might be interested in something a bit different. The Baal Molag Myrrh. There's a legend about stonefire men who brought the light of justice to the land. They were thieves, they stole only from the unjust and gave to those in need. They vanished early in the Third Era and have not been seen. Jim believes it is time for them to return. These gloves were used by the Baal Molag Myrrh to carry their burning stones from the Red Mountain. When you are ready to rekindle the fires of the Baal Molag Myrrh, wear the gloves and speak with Jim again. Okay, cool. Oh, we're gonna put those on now. I don't know if we need both, but we might. Let's do some Baal Molag Myrrh stuff. Something simple for the first mission. Need us to return the Flervu Locket. Brandis Flervu is a poor retired egg miner, gave his family's treasured locket to the taxman this year. The locket is now being held in Venom Manor with the rest of the taxes. Wear the gloves and pay a visit to Venom Manor in Aldrun. Find the locket and return it to Brainus Lervu in the name of Balagmar. Okay, we want to do the Baal Molag Myrrh quest before we do the Advanced Thieves Guild quest, because once you finish those, Jim's gone from the game. Although I don't know if we can, I don't think we can finish those, can we? Because I think we need to kill the head of the Fighters Guild. There's a lot of infighting between the various Imperial factions in this game. It's something that is sorely missed from recent Elder Scrolls games, if I'm going to be honest.
Go ahead.
But
I'm listening.
In the meantime, let's go check out what quests we can get from the temple. Indrin Lethen, do you have any duties? A holy woman here in Vivec is spreading the divine disease. Someone must convince Tanusia Viloth to leave Vivec City. Okay. Holy pilgrim and well-loved by the people. Do not kill her unless there is no other way. Try and convince her to go to the Corpusarium before she spreads the divine disease. She is very devout and would be most easily impressed by some show of your devotion to the temple's teachings. Okay, well, I could probably just convince her because I have really high personality, so that shouldn't be too much of an issue. I think Tanusia is here in the arena canton in the sewers, but I can't be sure.
Haven't I heard of you?
Oh, you're a dreamer. Let's get away from you. I really don't want to fight that guy. I don't see Tanusia, though. That's a problem. Okay, if she's not in the arena canton, I don't know where she is. I've completely forgotten. That's not great. Might as well pick up, like, the actual Thieves Guild quests from Jim Stacy while we're in Vivec. Track down Nad Theron. He used to hang out at the Elva Nation Corner Clubs here in Vivec's Hollow Campon. Supposed to deliver a key, find out what happened to him. If he's dead, find his key. Okay. Easy enough. Aha! I knew she was in the arena canton.
It is such an honor to meet you.
It is. It is such an honor to meet me. So you should probably get out of here before you infect everyone. Listen, it's 2021. We care about diseases and stopping the spread thereof. Or at least some of us do. Where do I talk to you about this? Leave Vivec City. Why should I do this as a favor for me? I believe you are a decent Khajiit at heart. Oh, well, thanks. Go to the Corpusarium because you have asked so kindly. Well, that's good. If only everything worked like that. Alright, she has left Vivec City. Glad we were able to convince her. Okay. Please take 2 cure blight disease potions. I don't think those are going to help, but sure. What else? Make the pilgrimage to the Sanctus Shrine. To make the pilgrimage, you must swear to silence. If you speak with anyone before reaching the shrine, you'll have broken our vow. For your sworn to silence, you may wish to purchase some potions of levitation or water walking. There's no easy way to get to the Sanctus Shrine in Dagonfell, and the waters can be dangerous. I'll wait. You may wait as long as we wish. Okay, good. That's not too difficult, but we do have stuff to do in Vivec first. Do you know about Nad Theron? Saw him from time to time, but never spoke to him. Okay, what about you, bartender?
I'm listening.
You know your customers, don't you? Really couldn't say. You're not helpful. Glathel, you have literally nothing to say. Arvami Rothri spoke with him the last time he was in here. Might check his residence, but don't know where he lives. Ask Gadella. She knows her customers well, though she's reticent to speak of them. Arvama is
if there's anything
right
I can
over
do,
here.
I am humbly at your service.
Hey, you said you didn't speak to him. What's that about? What am I suggesting? I don't know. What am I suggesting? All right, Gadella. Now do you want to tell me where he is? It would be nice. Fine. I'll pay you money. There, 100 gold. Tell me where Nads lives. So I'm speaking with Arvemi Rethri. Haven't seen him in a while. Check over in St. Dylan Canton, Southside Canal Works. That's where he lives. Okay, cool. Oh, well, that's not good. He still has his key, though, so whoever killed him didn't do it for the key. We could go confront his killer, hint hint, no spoilers. But that would involve, you know, fighting a murderer. So why don't we just go turn in the key and call it a day. Here is the key. Great. Keep an eye on Arvama Rathri. I believe she may be working for the Kimona Tong. Okay, 500 gold, great. Practice our skills. Okay, more jobs? Fighter's Guild is betraying the Empire for Kimona Tong money. Perseus Mercius, the old guildmaster in Aldrun, might be willing to help us fight. Okay. Used to be master of the Fighter's Guild before the Kimona Tong got involved. I believe he will help us fight the Kimona Tong. Speak with him and listen to what he has to say. Report back with any information. That's going to be it for this episode, folks. Tune in next week for the long and treacherous journey from Vivec City all the way up to this northern island while taking a vow of silence, so no fast travel. This is a bit of a tricky one, but we'll manage. See you there!